Introducing the FA-XX, a new fighter jet that's set to take the place of the F-22 Raptor and the F-35 Lightning II as the ultimate aircraft in the sky. With military forces across the globe racing to develop the first true sixth-gen stealth fighter, it's surprising that the Navy, rather than the Air Force, might just be the one to lead the charge. But with what exactly? Well, we've actually got a preliminary image of the FA-XX's expected design, and it reveals some interesting insights. The new aircraft will feature a tailless blended wing body, BWB design, where the wings seamlessly merge with the fuselage, eliminating vertical stabilizers. The air intakes are fully recessed, likely designed to mitigate any issues with detectability. Based on this, we can assume that stealth is a priority for the FA-XX, and it will probably incorporate the most cutting-edge radar-absorbing materials available. But stealth is not the only element that will define this aircraft as a new leader in avionics. Before it can claim that title, the FA-XX will need to solve some of the problems that current-generation stealth fighters face. In many jets, vertical tail surfaces aid with yaw control and boost maneuverability. Fifth-generation fighters typically feature these in the form of twin-canted tails in a V-shape, which help minimize the fighter's radar cross-section, or RCS, which is essentially how detectable the aircraft is on radar. However, these vertical stabilizers still act as obvious indicators of the jet's presence. Moreover, the large inlets that these aircraft sport are essential for producing thrust, but can create a resonance that's detectable by low-frequency radar arrays. On top of that, each F-35C costs the Navy around $117.3 million, and that's not even considering the $1.3 trillion in lifecycle costs associated with the F-35 program over its 66-year lifespan. Not exactly a good investment when you consider the outdated technology. With the FA-XX's new design, it appears the Navy will address all these issues at a more affordable cost, while also achieving greater speed and range than ever before. While radar technology has certainly advanced since the inception of fifth-gen fighters, so have anti-access and area denial A2/AD systems, along with other countermeasures that make it increasingly difficult for aircraft to approach enemy targets. The Chinese DF-21D, for example, was referred to as the world's first carrier killer, capable of launching a 600-kilogram payload up to 2,150 kilometers, 1,336 miles. Then came the DF-26B, reportedly doubling its predecessor's capabilities with a payload of 1,800 kilograms and a range of up to 4,000 kilometers, 2,485 miles. And that's not even considering the DFZF, a hypersonic glide vehicle launched from the DF-17 that can travel at speeds between Mach 5 and Mach 10, with a range of up to 1,930 kilometers or 1,199 miles. China's weaponry is not only formidable, but it's also strategically positioned within their A2AD zones in the South China Sea, East China Sea, and the Taiwan Strait, all of which are crucial access points to the Chinese mainland. These weapons pose a serious threat to anything within range. The F-35C has a flight range of around 1,200 nautical miles, meaning its combat range is only 600 nautical miles. Therefore, if these aircraft are to engage in missions over Chinese territory, they would already be within range of various Chinese countermeasures before launching from the carrier. As a result, the FA-XX will need superior stealth capabilities to penetrate deeper into enemy territory, while also ensuring it has a combat range sufficient to launch from a safe distance without exposing aircraft carriers to hypersonic missiles and other threats. This may require the FA-XX to operate at even longer ranges than previously anticipated. While 1,000 miles might seem adequate for combat range, as mentioned earlier, the DF-26B can exceed that range, potentially threatening anything within 2,500 miles if the reports hold true. By the time the FA-20 is fully developed, it will need to be capable of countering these current and future threats. Additionally, it will need to outpace the F-35 and other fifth-gen jets in terms of speed to execute its missions effectively. Most fifth-generation fighters use turbofan engines, such as the Pratt & Whitney F-135, which provide the bulk of the thrust. This allows the F-35 to achieve operational speeds of Mach 1.6, approximately 1,200 miles per hour, even with a full weapons load. Initially, it seemed that these engines would be the basis for sixth-gen fighter propulsion as well, but it's now clear that the new engines will likely be adaptive cycle engines A, C, E. In an A system, the engine can function as both a turbofan and a turbojet, adjusting its airflow based on the flight conditions. This allows the system to optimize fuel efficiency while maintaining speeds exceeding Mach 2 at altitudes around 65,000 feet. However, since the XA-100 engine is still under development, we'll need to wait and see how far this engine pushes the performance envelope. Meanwhile, the FA-20 will feature other groundbreaking elements that will shape the future of warfare. While radar systems have proven useful, they have their limitations. Modern Integrated Air Defense Systems, IADS, have made it increasingly difficult for stealth fighters to carry out meaningful operations without exposing themselves to risk. To counter this, the FA-XX will need to evolve the current generation avionics and sensor suites. The aircraft will likely incorporate infrared search and track, IRST, systems that passively detect heat signatures without emitting a frequency of their own. Additionally, the FA-20 will have the ability to execute electronic warfare measures, such as radar jamming, to prevent detection before it reaches its target. All of this will be supported by a sensor fusion system that consolidates and shares data across the aircraft's various components, enabling the pilot to make faster and more informed decisions. But the true game changer will be the ability of the FA-XX to seamlessly coordinate with a fleet of drones. As part of the sixth-generation fighter concept, the FA-XX will likely utilize the Loyal Wingman concept, or Collaborative Combat Aircraft, CCA. This would mean that the manned FA-XX would fly alongside up to four drones, each capable of performing various tasks, from acting as decoys to gathering intelligence. Imagine a scenario where the FA-XX flies deep into enemy territory, sending one drone ahead to neutralize electronic threats, one to cover the rear, and two more to act as decoys or to deter any defensive actions. The potential applications are nearly limitless, especially with the integration of AII and advanced data-sharing technologies. With AII, the drones could carry out their tasks autonomously, relieving the pilot from micromanaging the fleet. The pilot would still maintain overall control, but the drones would function as an extension of the aircraft, allowing the FA-XX to operate like a small armada capable of overwhelming any adversary. While the Navy takes the lead in advancing air combat, some wonder what the Air Force is doing. After all, they've been the dominant force in aviation for decades. However, the F-22 Raptor and other Air Force aircraft have been essential in pushing technology forward, which is why the Air Force is focusing on the Next Generation Air Dominance NGAD initiative. The NGAD aims to bring the U.S. Air Force into the future of sixth-generation stealth fighters. But the project has faced numerous setbacks, including redesigns and funding issues, with some contractors pulling out, like Northrop. By contrast, despite the lack of an official contractor, no one has backed out of the FA-XX project, and many are fully committed to its development. Additionally, while NGAD will focus purely on air superiority, the FA-XX will take on multiple roles, making it a much more versatile option. This suggests that the Navy might not just lead in avionics, but they could do so completely independently from the Air Force and other military branches. In conclusion, the FA-XX isn't just a fighter jet. It's a pioneer in stealth technology, artificial intelligence, data sharing, and more. But is it the ultimate aircraft or just the beginning of yet another arms race? Until next time.